peace and blessings. You tuned in to the Universal Knowledge Show, where all knowledge ties to all knowledge, no matter how far or near. Today, people, we have to talk about how we're going to be able to communicate with our people in a better fashion than fighting and arguing. I know a lot of people know about the beauty supply nail shop process that's going on amongst our people. It shouldn't even be so much of a rally. It should just be that we need to lead our money out of their hands. We need to stop giving them our money. I mean, sisters, all this, I love my hair, I love my nails, I love my toes, and allow enemies such as this, that's enemies to our economical benefit in our communities, to control you with 50% off and things like that and so on and so forth. Another thing too, is that we see black women say, black man, where you at? Protect us, protect us. When we have stuff like that unchecked that make other brothers think in another way, like, why should we? When we try to do that, this is what we get. But being that sister, that girl wasn't even really what we would consider a sister, you know what I'm saying? Y'all sit there and let half-breed mulatto do all that stuff in front of all y'all. Some of y'all didn't even say nothing. Just stood there waiting to go up in there. How y'all, when y'all continue to feed the system of white supremacy, Asian supremacy, Arab supremacy, so on and so forth. But now I'm not going to sit here and blame just that because all of us still spending in businesses that we don't even have in our community. So despite that, that should let people know that these are forefronts of how people feel about us. For us to get socked in the mouth by Asians and beat up with sticks and stuff like that, that tells you about what they feel about you. Okay, that's all the folks that come here. You know what I'm saying? The setup shop. They already painted a picture of, and it ain't mind of how black people are according to how this racist media has portrayed black people in America. So automatically, they're going to come with an attitude against you as a black person because the media has painted this false picture only on selected few of our people, but it's linked to all of us. So our job is really to just stop giving our money to these foreigners, straight up. Because the money we're giving them, that money we're giving them, we can do it for ourselves. There's a lot of sisters got beauty supply and stores, and then so in nail shops and so on and so forth. Stop the envy and hate amongst each other and backstabbing amongst each other and go spend your money with them despite you liking that sister or not. Long as you know you put money in these brothers and sisters' pouch. I had a shirt a while back that said, Supporting black businesses support black families. You know, and it's a deep thing. I do want people to know that, man, we need to start incorporating businesses that's going to work. That's what I'm working on. I'm working on trying to get my own cannabis thing jumping off. I'm already there. Okay, I'm already here to pick up stuff. I was waiting for the order to fulfill, and I go pick up my orders, and then I'm on a mission. And then I can post and do what I need to do as a host. But I will be giving you a footage of how it worked, how it go. I'm just learning everything within the facility, education-wise, so I will be able to convert this information to brothers that have money, just blowing enough money to be able to open up one of these million-dollar cash styles, because many of these places make a lot of money. But this was basically a tap-in. This is a shot out sisters to say, hey, all you sisters to say here that you're good women, all you sisters to say that you're not like that, or you're not ratchet, or you're educated, and so forth. Well, the education will be to check all the hood rats, or whatever you want to call them, hood rats, gangs, ratchet females, whatever you want to call them, because I'm not going to call you a woman, no matter how much you want to ask for. You have to earn that privilege to consider a woman. You know what I'm saying? You're a woman, but you're linked. You're rich women. There's a lot of rich women running around here. You know what I'm saying? Not only just black women, all type of rich women running around here. I'm just addressing our own. We need to start addressing it. Just like we have to address our niggas in community killing. That's why I don't care about talking about these gangbangers and all that shit. It's my job to speak on that. You know what I'm saying? I once was there, so I got to speak against it. If I'm a bigger man, then I'm a man, a mature man, a real man, a full understanding, conscious man, to know that this is genocide in our community. No matter how they put it, how they change it, how they creep it don't matter what you do. It's genocide of its own people, period. Same with you sisters going in there letting these Asians get your money, and they teaching their kids to hate you just as much as all the other races teaching their kids to hate you, but they'll take your money. It's time for us to learn from them and do the same thing and stop fighting behind bullshit that doesn't even support us. Those people don't support us in no fashion. They're already over there in Africa trying to get in over there the same way the European did when they came over there. So they ain't doing nothing but exchanging slave masters, throwing away the white ones and taking on the Arabs I mean, throwing on the white ones and taking on the Asian, white Asians. They're going to wind up being put back in another form of slavery, another, because it pisses me off how all my brothers and sisters around the planet have to be discriminated against like this. Mainly in America, we still can't see. We still can't see how we are so messed up, how we are so destroyed as a people. And when people such as myself and many other brothers out there doing that, we consider fools, or we're dumb because we won't join the bandwagon genocide. We're crazy because we speak against what's destroying you. We're crazy because we're speaking down against all the things that we put in our communities, as well as our food, our water, our education, and so on and so forth. We're crazy speaking about it. We're crazy all about what's coming on ahead of a time. We're crazy telling you what this government is trying to do to us and many others. You're crazy. We're crazy telling you that you are indigenous to this land. You're crazy because you're trying to tell us that Jesus never existed. You're crazy. Now what y'all got to say about all the crazy things that us crazy people said the prior 10 years? And I can point them out. I won't do it on this segment, but we can point it out where all us crazy so-called woke brothers, I don't want to use conscious no more because conscious has been tainted with a lot of buffoons and agents and shit. So I'm gonna put it on that level, woke. But at the same time, peace and love, family. Please hit the button and subscribe. This is your brother, Jake Holman, logging out. Peace and love.